Hello, I'm Sophie Rovner from the American Chemical Society. Welcome to this media briefing from ACS Spring 2022. Your next trendy handbag could be fashioned from leather made from a fungus. Researchers are reporting at the ACS meeting that they have harnessed this organism to convert food waste into sustainable faux leather, as well as paper products and cotton substitutes, with properties comparable to the traditional materials. This fungal leather takes less time to produce than existing substitutes already on the market, and unlike some, is 100% bio-based. To tell us more about this research, we're joined by Dr. Akram Zamoni from the University of Borås in Sweden. Thank you for joining us today.
Hello, thank you very much for this opportunity that we can present the results of our research.
Where did you get the idea to do this project?
We have several years of research experience when it comes to using of filamentous fungi for resource recovery, like recovering different materials from the waste and residues. So we have started with that, like with the biotechnology processes where we use fungi to recover the resources. So when the fungi is growing, they are making some tiny fibers. And I had this idea with me all the time that maybe someday one could take those fibers and create a textile material. So the idea is from like that research that I have been involved many years ago.
All right, so how did you investigate this?
So we started cultivating the filamentous fungi on food waste to start. We started with bread waste or the unsold bread fractions that are available in the supermarkets. So we grow the filamentous fungi on bread, and then we harvest the fungal biomass. Then we try to create a method that we can spin the yarn from that fungi, but also develop the method where we could make a leather-like material from the fungi grown on food waste.
And what did you find out?
Starting from the yarn production, so when we harvest the filamentous fungi, so it's a biomass which we have to treat to remove the protein fraction, for example, and get the fibrous fraction, which we can make the fibers out of them. So we have developed a wet staining process where we could create monofilaments, and then those monofilaments, they are showing tensile properties quite comparable to the existing textiles, but also they are showing some additional good properties like biocompatibility, antimicrobial properties that make them ideal choices for medical textile applications. When it comes to our leather production process, the material that we get, it's a soft material with the mechanical properties quite comparable to the animal leather, which is in the market. So we are having good properties and comparable with the existing materials so far. And we are trying, of course, to improve the process.
All right. So what's the significance of your findings?
So our research deals with two big questions, two big concerns in the society. In one direction, we have food waste, which means a lot of economic and environmental issues. And on the other hand, we have textiles that we have shortage of cotton, and we have those synthetic textiles that they have a lot of environmental issues. for example, release of microplastics into the environment and so on. So our research combined these two problems and try to come with something new, which is good for the environment. In one hand, we take care of food waste, so it will be like recovery of the nutrients towards something which is useful. And on the other hand, we are creating a material which is sustainable, which is biodegradable, and hopefully it can like perform as good as the existing materials. So in all directions, our project has good benefits for the environment.
Now, there are already some other fungal leathers on the market. What's the advantage of your methods and products?
So one of the main differences in the production process is that like those existing leather-like materials, which are so-called mycelium leathers, they are produced in a fermentation or cultivation process, which is called solid state fermentation. Those type of processes, usually they are taking several days or maybe weeks to finish. So it takes a lot of time to prepare a mycelium leather. On the other hand, what the process we are using is so-called stop-merge fermentation, where we mix the food material, for example, the bread waste, which is the material which we have started with, and with water, and then let the fungi to grow on this medium. So presence of water results in a much quicker growth for the fungi. So it means we can produce the same amount of material maybe in a couple of days. So this is one of the big differences. On the other hand, so there is not so much detail still published about the mycelium leather, but from what we know, still in those type of products, they have to use a supporting layer, which is like synthetic polymer, like a polyester. And then what we have in our leather-like material is that it's 100% bio-based, so we are not using any petroleum-based materials in our formulation. So it's 100% like bio-based materials. So, which is again, of course, good for the environment.
Yes, and does that mean that your leather and paper materials and textiles would be biodegradable?
Yes, that's what we expect. We are going to test it in the lab to make sure, but since we are working with only like bio-based materials, biopolymers, biobinders, so we do expect that we have a biodegradable material.
All right. And what do your leather and paper materials feel like?
The leather-like material, it's soft, like quite similar to the feeling of a real leather material. And the plastic materials, they are like stronger, but a little bit more brittle. So more like a plastic material.
What's the next step in your research?
So the next step would be that we do the scale up, of course, both in the like cultivation process where we can produce several kilos of the material, and also in the processing where we produce the end product. So the scale up and also designing the like prototypes based on this new type of textile is the next step in our project.
Do you have plans to commercialize your process or your products?
Yes, we hope so. There are already some companies that are interested to invest on this type of textile materials, and hopefully, yeah, in the near future, we can see the scale up of the process and a real product in the market.
All right. What do you want viewers to take away from your talk? What's the key message?
I think our research, like as well as all other research, which are about like bio-based textiles are all dealing with the same type of problem, that we have to do something with the environment. We cannot just keep using the synthetic-based textiles and then keep sending pollutions to the sea and to the environment. There is time now to come with the alternative materials. And fungal-based textile materials and leather-like materials, someday they can replace the existing unsustainable type of textiles.
Thank you, Akram, for sharing your research with us.
Thank you very much.
Be sure to check out our other media briefings for ACS Spring 2022, which will be posted throughout the meeting at www.acs.org/ACS Spring 2022 briefings.